In this film, we're going to go ahead and show you how to rebuild a dry air spool valve. The easiest way to rebuild it is go ahead and take it off of your either your booster or your pump. You will need three tools: snap ring pliers, a spool removal tool that we sell here at Maxpro Technologies, and a hammer. Start by taking the snap ring off. Once the snap ring's off, you want to turn it sideways in your vise. Use the spool tool remover. You can start tapping the spool out. And while you're tapping the spool out, the cap will come out. This is the cap. Here's your spool. And at this point here, you can go ahead and remove the sleeve. There are holes in the sleeve itself that the end of this tool fit into. Get that in place. Go ahead with the hammer. Tap the sleeve out. Once the sleeve is out, you can go ahead and remove the O-rings that are on the spool and the sleeve and start rebuilding it. On the sleeve itself, some good information to know, there are 6 grooves for O-rings. Actually 6 of the grooves, only 5 out of the 6 grooves get O-rings on them. There's a vent hole in one of the grooves that needs to be left open. So those are the O-rings for the spool sleeve. For the spool itself, the way the dry air spool works, there is an O-ring that goes on first, and then there is a glide ring that goes over the O-ring to protect it in drier air environments. The glide ring will slide over the empty grooves. And once it gets onto the O-ring, you'll have to give it a little bit of force, but it should slide right over the O-ring then also. And then just continue this until they're all filled. After you get all the O-rings and glide rings on the spool, a good idea what we usually do is put a little bit of lubricant on the seals. After putting the O-rings and the glide rings on the spool, you're ready to install it into the sleeve. We found the best way to do it is use a vise this way here, that everything is square when you're assembling it, and it keeps you from nicking the glide rings as it's pressing into the sleeve. Just kind of get it started here. Just make sure everything's nice and straight. Go ahead, and you can kind of feel the glide rings as they enter. You can kind of feel them seating, okay? So it gets in all the way. Go ahead and press it down. And you can kind of, with your finger, shift it back and forth just to make sure if there's anything is cut, you'll feel that as it's sliding back and forth. At this point here, the dry air spool sleeve complete is ready to be installed into the housing. There again, never hurts to put a little bit of lubrication on the O-rings. And with the housing, go ahead and press it down. Put your spool cap back in place. Your snap rings. And at that point there, your rebuild is finished.